Sixth grade, module 4, lesson 5, problem set. Complete the table by filling in the blanks. Use a calculator when needed. So 3 to the 5th power in expanded form would be 3 multiplied by itself 5 different times. So 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. And we can solve this. And I'm going to do 3. If I push this button, x to the y, 3 to the 5th power, that's equal to 243. And again, I'm using this app. It's called the calculator. You might have a calculator, a scientific calculator at home, or if you don't, it's free. You can download this app. But we got 243 in standard form. So then we have 4 times 4 times 4, which in exponential form would be 4, and there are 1, 2, 3 of them. So the exponent would be 3, 4 to the 3rd power. 4 times 4 is 16, and 16 times 4 is 64. So I don't need a calculator for that one. 1 and 9 tenths to the 2nd power, that would be 1 and 9 tenths times 1 and 9 tenths. 1 and 9 tenths to the 2nd power is 3 and 61 hundredths. And then 1 half to the 5th power would be 1 half times 1 half. We're going to do it 5 times. 1 half times 1 half. So our numerator is going to be 1, because 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 is 1. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8, 8 times 2 is 16, and 16 times 2 would be 32. So this would be 1/32. Number 2, why do whole numbers raised to an exponent get greater while fractions raised to an exponent get smaller? So it's kind of talking about, like, for example, this 4 to the 3rd power got bigger. It's 64. But when we did 1 half to the 5th power, we got 1/32, which is smaller. And this is because when we're multiplying by a whole number, we're multiplying by groups of them, so they're getting larger, a whole number. But when we're multiplying by a fraction, which is only part of something, and then we multiply it by another thing that's only part of it, it's going to keep getting smaller. So let's say as whole numbers are multiplied by themselves, they get larger. Fractions get smaller because we are finding part of a part. Number 3. The powers of 2 that are in range, the powers of 2 that are in the range 2 through 1000 are 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, and 512. Find all the powers of 3 that are in the range 3 through 1000. So they're saying that we want But the powers of 2, meaning 2 to the 1st power, is 2. 2 to the 2nd power was 4. 2 to the 3rd power is 8. 2 to the 4th is 16. That's 2 to the 5th, 2 to the 6th, 2 to the 7th, 2 to the 8th, 2 to the 9th, and then 2 to the 10th is over 1,000, so they stopped. They want us to do that with 3. So powers of 3. So 3 to the 1st power would just be 3. 3 to the 2nd power, 3 times 3, is 9. 3 to the 3rd power, 3 times 3 times 3, 9 times 3 is 27. 3 to the 4th power, so 27 times 3, or we can do 3 to the 4th power is 81. And while we're here, let's do 3 to the 5th power. So we have 81 and then 243. So let's do 3 to the 6th power. And 3 to the 7th if we need. So this is basically 243 times 3. So let's do 3 to the 6th is 729. And 3 to the 7th is greater. So we just need 3 to the 6th, which was 729. So if we wanted to list those, we have 3, 9, 27, 81, 243, and 729. So now find all the powers of 4 in the range 4 through 1,000. We're going to do the same thing. Let's find 4 to the first power is 4. 4 to the second power, or 4 times 4 is 16. 4 to the third power, 4 times 4 times 4, so 16 times 4 is 64. 4 to the fourth power would be equal to 4 to the fourth is 256. 4 to the fifth is over 1,000, so we're just going to stop at 256. So we have 4, 16, 64, and 256. Number 5, write an equivalent expression for n times a using only addition. So n times a means that we're multiplying, so we could do something like 3 times 4. Sometimes it's easier for me to look at it with numbers. So if we have 3 groups of 4, we would have 4 plus 4 plus 4. So let's translate that into n times a. So we would have a plus a plus a plus a however many times n tells us. So this is n times. So we add a the number of times that n tells us to. Number 6, write an equivalent expression for w to the b using only multiplication. Explain what w is in this new expression. Explain what b is in this new expression. So w to the b, so w is the base and b is our exponent. So w to the b would be equal to, we're going to multiply w however many times b tells us to. So we're just going to do w times w times w. I'm just going to put some dots, times w, however many times b tells us to. Explain what w is in this new expression. So w is the base or the factor that is repeatedly multiplied. Multiplied by itself. Let's be more specific. And then what is b in this new situation? So b is the number of times it's going to be multiplied. So b is the number of times that w will be multiplied by itself. So why do we use this? Number 7 saying, what's the advantage of using exponential notation? So it's just a quick way to write something. So rather than writing 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, that takes up a lot of space and some time. So it's just a simpler way to write, for example, like 2 to the 7th power. So it's just some way to get where you need to go a little bit quicker. So let's say it's a quicker way to write a multiplication expression. When the factors are all the same. And number 8, what is the difference between 4x and x to the fourth power? Evaluate both of these expressions when x equals 2. So 4x, that means 4 times x. It's kind of confusing that they used x. It means 4, I'll use a little dot for x, so it means 4 times x. So, or x plus x plus x plus x, so x 4 times. Whereas x to the fourth power, that means that we are multiplying x by itself 4 different times. So x times x times x times x. So if x is 2, then 4x will be equal to 4 times 2. So it's equal to 8. When we do x to the fourth power, or 2 to the fourth power, we get 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. And 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16. So that's the difference between those two expressions.